Okay. Hi, guys. Please, can you tell the other students to go online so we can start? So as we explained last time, that most of the glucose will undergo a regular glycolysis. This is the normal pathway of metabolism. However, 10% of the glucose will enter into what is called pentose phosphate pathway. Okay, so in this pathway, as we will see in the coming slide, so in this pathway, we have two different phases. We have the oxidative phases and we have the non-oxidative phases, okay? And the idea of the non-oxidative phases is that we will obtain an intermediate of the glycolysis. So we will be obtaining a component that will be an intermediate of the glycolysis, so we can go back to glycolysis, okay? So again, it's a revision, what I'm explaining now. I will go now to the scheme. Okay. So in this scheme, as you can see, as we mentioned last time, that the glucose will undergo the pentose phosphate pathway. So what will happen exactly? Exactly, the glucose, if you have the slide with you, so the glucose will give glucose 6-phosphate through glycolysis. This is the first step of the glycolysis. And then, if you remember, then the glucose will give glucose 6-phosphate and then we'll continue in the glycolysis. Here, the glucose 6-phosphate will do a deviation. In this deviation, the glucose 6-phosphate, under the activity of an enzyme called the glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase, will give me 6-phosphogluconate. But here in parallel, a very important reaction will take place. Here, as you can see, we have the GSSG, the oxidized glutathione, and we have the reduced glutathione. So this is the normal minor pathway. So the normal, when I say normal, يعني هيدا موجود عند normal persons. عند normal persons, the oxidized glutathione will be reduced into reduced glutathione. Reduced glutathione is very important for our body. It will maintain our body and it will avoid the stressful conditions. Because if we have only oxidized glutathione, oxidized glutathione are among the oxidative factors that will expose our body to stress. This stress can lead to hemolytic anemia. ببلشوا red blood cells يكسروا حالهم. ممكن نوصل للفتيق والصفيرة etc. Okay. So again, بعد هون عم نحكي نحن revision. So the 6-phosphogluconate will give me ribulose 5-phosphate. هذا ribulose 5-phosphate either بيكمل to give me ribose 5-phosphate, which is a component of nucleotide, or it can undergo non-oxidative phase. هذا ribulose 5-phosphate بيرجع وبيعطيني glucose 6-phosphate. والglucose 6-phosphate بيقدو gluconeogenesis بيرجع بيعطيني glucose. Okay? So this is the normal pathway. But we will see that we can have some cases called inborn errors. Inborn errors are diseases, okay, موجودين inherited, okay, بيناتهم الفافيزم. So what does it mean, favism? Favism أو التفويل. So favism بتشوفه أول ما يخلق البيبي بيقولوا له خلينا نعمل له فحص التفويل. شو يعني فحص التفويل؟ فحص التفويل يعني when we check if the person has a deficiency in an enzyme called the glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase. So which enzyme is the glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase? So here, if I go back to the slide here, we are supposed to have glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase, okay? So هول العالم اللي عندهم favism, they don't have this enzyme, the glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase. So if they don't have this enzyme, they have a deficiency in this enzyme, automatically, that means that the oxidized glutathione will not be reduced into a reduced glutathione. So the oxidized glutathione will remain oxidized glutathione, and this will subject ourselves to oxidative stress, oxidative factors. So again, the people suffering from favism, اللي عندهم مرض التفويل هيدا inherited diseases, okay, they do not, they had a deficiency in this enzyme. إذا عندهم, if this enzyme is not existent automatically, ما حيصير عندنا oxidized glutathione will be reduced. It will not be reduced. It will remain oxidized and this will expose me to stressful factor. Okay. Again, كمان اللي عندهم favism, the fava beans or the fool contain a glucoside that can expose our body to oxidative stress. So, حنقلكم paragraph, the term favism indicate a severe reaction occurring after the ingestion of food containing beans. So, هي severe reaction بتصير بعد ما ناكل فول. It will manifest usually 6 to 24 hours of the fava beans, okay. This signs and symptoms result mainly بصير عندنا destruction of red blood cells بنسميها acute hemolytic anemia. So ببلش red blood cells يكسروا حالهم. لما يكسروا حالهم red blood cells شو بصير عندنا؟ بصير عندنا jaundice, بصير عندنا صفيرة, ومرات also it could be life threatening, it could be lethal. So favism can be prevented. How to prevent favism? How to prevent this factor? By an early screening of glucose 6 phosphate dehydrogenase. أول ما يخلق الولد بشوفوا له إذا عنده هيدا الإنزيم. If this enzyme is not present automatically, he's not allowed to eat fava beans because fava beans are rich in glucosides, and these glucosides will expose our body to stressful factors. Okay, so automatically here we can say that the deficiency of a glucose 6 phosphate dehydrogenase mainly should be screened, okay, at a very early level, يعني دغري بعد الولادة, and by education they should know that they should limit their intake of fava beans, okay. So لازم نحن نعرف إنه maintaining reduced glutathione is very important, لأنه reduced glutathione in normal scenario will prevent the oxidative damage in erythrocytes. So إذا في عنا reduced glutathione ما بصير عنا تكسير أو hemolytic anemia أو بتكسر red blood cells. بس in case كان ما عنا reduced glutathione بصير عنا هيك. إذا ما عنا reduced glutathione يعني شو عنا oxidized glutathione. So that's why we are saying that a lack of adequate reduced glutathione in erythrocytes will put our body and our erythrocytes at a high risk of damage by oxidative stress that will lead to hemolytic anemia. Hemolytic anemia when the red blood cells will be broken down, okay? So reduced glutathione will protect our cells. بس اللي عندهم favism, they do not have reduced glutathione. ليه reduced glutathione قليل عندهم؟ لأنه عندهم deficiency بالإنزيم, automatically oxidized glutathione will not be converted into reduced glutathione, and automatically they will suffer from oxidative stress leading to the destruction of red blood cells and leading also to jaundice, to dark urine, and to many other problems, okay? So what is really important is to know about oxidized glutathione and the importance of having reduced glutathione. So again, the people suffering from favism, they do not have this enzyme, glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase. If they do not have this enzyme, automatically the oxidized glutathione will not be converted into reduced glutathione. It will remain oxidized. It will expose our body to stress. It will lead to hemolytic anemia, jaundice, and other problems. So this is what is called favism. So in the next slide, we will see the favism. Okay, so favism is a disease, inherited diseases, mainly due to the deficiency in glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase. So the enzyme glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase can be deficient in some persons. It's a common problem in clinical practice. It will lead to drug-induced hemolytic anemia. So this same scenario can also be not only to the ingestion of fava beans, مش من ورا بس أكل الفول, من ورا كمان anti-malarial drugs, ممكن كمان يعمل هالشي. It is characterized by anemia and by jaundice, صفيرة and anemia. So again, تفويل مش موجود عن كل الناس. العالم النورمال, they do have the glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase, the oxidized glutathione will be reduced into reduced glutathione, and automatically the body will be protected against stress and the red blood cells will not be broken down. But if we have the favism problem, we have a deficiency in the glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase, automatically the oxidized glutathione will remain oxidized, and this will lead to hemolytic anemia. Okay? So now, after finalizing the phosphate pathway, we will go directly. So we talked about favism. Now we'll go directly to the citric acid cycle, or what is called the Krebs cycle. Okay. So if you remember, we talked about glycolysis. So in the glycolysis, during the glycolysis, the glucose, one glucose will give me by the end two pyruvates. Okay, two pyruvate. And I told you that the pyruvate later on can undergo Krebs cycle. But the pyruvate to undergo Krebs cycle, they should give me acetyl-CoA. And acetyl-CoA is the one who will undergo the Krebs cycle to release ATP and to be broken down into CO2. So keep in mind that acetyl-CoA is a two-carbon molecule. So Krebs cycle is very important. It's the link between catabolic and anabolic pathways, and it will provide a precursor to synthesize some amino acids and nucleotides. So now you will not understand this point specifically indeed, because we did not talk till now about amino acids, but we should know that. Later on, we will talk about the metabolism of the lipids, about the metabolism of proteins, and we already talked about the metabolism of carbs. The end point, or the last step of all the metabolisms, is the acetyl-CoA and the Krebs cycle. They will go reach this point. So here, we mentioned that we talk about the Krebs cycle. So this is the Krebs cycle. But before talking about the Krebs cycle, we need to know that, like, and we all know that, glucose through glycolysis will give me pyruvate. But pyruvate will undergo a preparatory step where the pyruvate derived from glycolysis under the activity of an enzyme called pyruvate dehydrogenase, the pyruvate will be oxidized into a molecule called acetyl-CoA. So this step is the link between glycolysis and the Krebs cycle. So again, during the glycolysis, the glucose will give me the pyruvate. The pyruvate cannot undergo the Krebs cycle. The pyruvate needs to be oxidized into another molecule called acetyl-CoA, and the acetyl-CoA will undergo the Krebs cycle. The passage from pyruvate to acetyl-CoA is an intermediate phase, very important, between the glycolysis and the acetyl-CoA. How it will happen to pass from pyruvate to acetyl-CoA? To pass from pyruvate to acetyl-CoA, we will be assisted by an enzyme called pyruvate dehydrogenase. This enzyme will oxidize the pyruvate into acetyl-CoA. And then here, the acetyl-CoA, okay, will go to the mitochondria to undergo the Krebs cycle, because you should know that all the enzymes of the Krebs cycle, who is called Krebs cycle or citric acid cycle, all the enzymes of the Krebs cycle are located inside the mitochondria. So it's very important to have the preparatory steps where acetyl-CoA will enter the cycle to start getting oxidized. And the acetyl-CoA will be oxidized in the Krebs cycle to do what? To release CO2, to release ATP. Sometimes it will help in the fatty acid. So here you can see a small figure where we can see that acetyl-CoA, the glucose will give me pyruvate. The pyruvate will be converted into acetyl-CoA. We will see later on that among the lipids, the fatty acids will be converted into acetyl-CoA. And we will see also that the amino acids can be converted to acetyl-CoA. So that's why I was telling you that acetyl-CoA is the end point of all the metabolism. So if we go back to the citric acid cycle, we can see that acetyl-CoA will be converted into citrate, the citrate into isocitrate, isocitrate into alpha-ketoglutarate. And at this point, the alpha-ketoglutarate will be a contact point with the amino acid metabolism. We won't talk about it now, but remember alpha-ketoglutarate. Alpha-ketoglutarate will give me succinyl-CoA, succinyl-CoA, succinate, succinate, fumarate, fumarate, malate, malate oxaloacetate. First of all, you should know that one pyruvate will give me one acetyl-CoA. But initially, one glucose gave me two pyruvate. So here, if I'm starting with one glucose molecule, I have two pyruvate, and two pyruvate will give me two acetyl-CoA, and I will continue. So here, instead of having one citrate, I will be having two citrate, two isocitrate. I will consume here two NADH and here two NADH. So I will consume four NADH, and I will release 2NADH. So هون إذا منطلع على citric acid cycle منشوف إنه between azocitrate and alpha-ketoglutarate I consumed 1NADH. sorry, I release one NADH, and here I release one NADH, and here I release one NADH, okay? So here everything should be multiplied by 2, and here instead of having 2 CO2, yani I have 4 CO2, and instead of releasing one ATP, I release 2 ATP. So I will explain the details of these steps later on. Okay, hold on, here are the details. If you can see the big table. Okay, so here we have a big table called ATP yield energetic of a glucose oxidation. Okay, so لازم نعرف لكن أول شيء, if we start from glucose, يعني from the glycolysis till the end of the Krebs cycle. So نحن what do we have exactly? We have from glucose to pyruvate, we have a glycolysis. And then the pyruvate will be converted into acetyl-CoA. So one glucose will give me 2 pyruvate, 2 pyruvate will give me 2 acetyl-CoA, and the 2 acetyl-CoA will continue to do the Krebs cycle. But all along the process, I will release NADH and I will release FADH2. The NADH and the FADH2 will undergo a process called electron phosphorylation. Electron phosphorylation. The electron phosphorylation will release ATP. Okay, so let's start. Like, from one glucose, okay, to glucose 6-phosphate, تتذكروا نحن خسرنا 1 ATP. From fructose 6-phosphate to fructose 1,6-biphosphate, خسرنا 1 ATP. From 2 glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate to 2,1,3-biphosphoglycerate, ربحنا 2 NADH. ورجعنا from 1,3, هون ليش كلهم 2؟ لا بتتذكروا ان نحن 1 glucose بدي يعطيني 2 pyruvate. Okay, so here the first 1 2 3 4 5 steps هن during the glycolysis. If you remember قلنا نحن during the glycolysis the net ATP is 2, so here you can notice we have 4 ATP and we lost 2 ATP, so the net total is 2 ATP and 2 NADH. Okay, so لازم نعرف انه ال1 ATP is 1 ATP. So number of ATP formed in the last column is 1. بينما 1 NADH through the electron phosphorylation process, it will release 2.5 ATP. يعني هون if I have 2 NADH, they will release 5 ATP. ليه هون محطوط 3 or 5؟ لأنه هون between the cytoplasm and between the mitochondria بصير عنا شوية losses بالNADH release of ATP. بس إذا بدكم تخدوها 5 ATP, okay? So here again, from 2,1,3-biphosphoglycerate to 2,3-phosphoglycerate, 2 ATP, يعني 2. So 2-phosphoenolpyruvate to 2-pyruvate, 2 ATP, يعني 2. طيب, the 2-pyruvate ل2-acetyl-CoA, اللي حكينا عنها من شوي, we release 2 NADH. If we release 2 NADH, يعني شو؟ يعني 2 times 2.5, يعني 5 ATP. بعدين قلنا نحن خلينا نرجع على الكريبس سايكل ونشوف. قلنا نحن انه بالكريبس سايكل شو طلعنا؟ رجع على الكريبس سايكل. بالكريبس سايكل from azocitrate to alpha ketoglutarate we released 1 NADH and 1 CO2. And from alpha ketoglutarate to succinyl CoA we released 1 NADH and 1 CO2. And from malate to oxaloacetate we released 1 NADH. طب هول كلهم لازم يصيروا times 2، يعني how many NADH I released؟ 1 2 3، يعني 3 times 2 يعني 6 NADH. يعني هون 2 2 and 2. 6 NADH كل مرة times 2.5 اوكي بيطلع لي 5 5 5. From 6-NIL-CoA to 6-NADH 2 ATP and from 6-NADH to fumarate 2 FADH2. So لازم أعرف أنه 1 FADH2 through electron phosphorylation it will release 1.5 ATP. 2 times 1.5 it is 3. Guys, شو problem؟ Guys, it's okay. I will record it and you will see it later on. It's fine. I know. ما أنا فتح PowerPoint in parallel so you can see it. You have to follow on your paper. If you can hear me, you follow on your paper. Okay? So again, in this table, we are summarizing the glycolysis and the Krebs cycle. Okay? and the electron phosphorylation. So kind of we will see from one glucose what we will obtain by the end. هارجع عيد. So منبلش. One glucose will give me one pyruvate, two pyruvates. But for one glucose to give me two pyruvates, we have many intermediate steps. خلينا نطلع هالستب إذا بتتذكرون الجلايكوليسيس. أول شيء, one glucose will give me one glucose six phosphate. Here I lose one ATP. برجع, one fructose six phosphate will give me one fructose 1,6-B phosphate. هون كمان I lose one ATP. So قدي خسرت two ATP. بس تتذكروا أنتوا بالجلايكوليسيس بطلع four ATP. بخسر اثنين بيطلع لي النت two. كمان بالجلايكوليسيس two glyceraldehyde three phosphate will give me 2,1,3 biphosphate glyceraldehyde two NADH. And 2,1,3-biphosphoglycerate will give me 2,3-phosphoglycerate, 2-ATP. And 2-phosphoenol pyruvate will give me 2-pyruvate, 2-ATP. So إذا بس بدي روح من الجلوكوز لهيدي step 2-pyruvate, هيدي كلها glycolysis. So during the glycolysis, I released 4-ATP, I consume 2-ATP. So how many net ATP I have? 2. بس كمان أنا, I released 2-NADH. NADH. After the Krebs cycle, we have a step called electron phosphorylation, where the NADH and the FADH2, they have a role to be converted into ATP. We keep in mind that one NADH will give me 2.5 ATP, and one FADH2 will give me 1.5 ATP. So here what I do, what I should do, I should multiply the NADH number by the 2.5 ATP. So 2 NADH, يعني 2 times 2.5, يعني 5 ATP. ليه هون حاطين 3 or 5؟ لأنه لازم نعرف إن الجلايكوليسيس بتصير بالسيتوبلازم, الكريبس سايكل بالميتوكوندريا. So as you can see تحت مكتوب, this number is 3 or 5 depending on the mechanism used to shuttle NADH equivalent from the cytosol to the mitochondria matrix. بس انتو خدوها 5 or 3 اثنيناتهم صح, okay? So, لكن during the glycolysis شو صار عنا؟ minus 1, minus 1, 2, 2, يعني 4 minus 2, يعني 2, and 5, يعني لهلأ 7 ATP. هلأ, during the Krebs cycle, what do we have? During the Krebs cycle, إذا منرجع على Krebs cycle, رجع سلايدين لورا. منبلش بالKrebs cycle بشو؟ بالأسيتيل-CoA. بس هي مش 1 أسيتيل-CoA, هيدي 2 أسيتيل-CoA. ليه؟ One pyruvate will give me one acetyl-CoA, but one glucose gave me two pyruvate, and the two pyruvate will give me two acetyl-CoA. So here I have two acetyl-CoA, and it will give me two citrate, two isocitrate, will release two NADH, two CO2, two alpha-ketoglutarate, two NADH, two CO2, two 6-enyl-CoA, two ATP, two 6-enate, two FADH2, two fumarate, two malate, two NADH, two oxaloacetate. يعني in total, هلا, I will go over every single step to check the release of ATP. From two pyruvate to two acetyl-CoA, I release two NADH, يعني 5 ATP, لأنه 2 times 2.5. From 2 isocitrate to 2 alpha ketoglutarate, I release 2 NADH, يعني 5 ATP. From 2 alpha ketoglutarate to 2 6-enyl CoA, I release 2 NADH, يعني 5 ATP. From 2 6-enyl CoA to 2 6-enate, I release 2 ATP, يعني 2 ATP. From 2 6-enate to 2 fumarate, I release 2 FADH2, يعني 3 ATP. Why 3? لأن 1 FADH2 and the electron phosphorylation will give me 1.5 ATP. If I have 2 FADH2, شو حيكون عندي 3 ATP. 2 malate will give me 2 oxaloacetate, 2 NADH, 5 ATP. So, minus 1, minus 1, plus 3 or 5, plus 2, plus 2, plus 5, plus 5, plus 5, plus 2, plus 3, plus 5, بيطلع لي 30 to 32. So every single glucose will give me around 30 to 32 ATP passing through glycolysis, Krebs cycle, and electron phosphorylation. Okay? So complete oxidation of acetyl-CoA. So acetyl-CoA, one acetyl-CoA will give me 2 CO2. واحدة على step number 3, واحدة على step number 4. So the one acetyl-CoA will give me 2 CO2, يعني 2 acetyl-CoA will give me 4 CO2, okay? So at ATP is being generated in the Krebs cycle, ولازم نعرف أنه citric acid cycle is the final common oxidative pathway for all foodstuff. يعني إذا أكلت شي fatty أو شي في sugar أو شي في protein, the last pathway of all foodstuff is the Krebs cycle. Okay? So again, لكن هون عم نشوف how we have an integration between the major metabolic pathway. So carbohydrates will give me pyruvate. Pyruvate will give me acetyl-CoA that will enter the Krebs cycle. Fatty acid will undergo something called beta oxidation. رح نشوفه بالنكست lecture. So fatty acid once oxidized, رح يعطوني acetyl-CoA. Acetyl-CoA should يعمل Krebs cycle to give me ATP. Amino acid هيمشي stress amination, هيعطيني شو؟ هيعطيني a product other food succinyl alpha ketoglutarate other food بال Krebs cycle. So هلا هون it's still early to go into the details, but we should know that the carbs, the fatty acids, and the amino acid will end up by reaching the Krebs cycle. Excess carbohydrates are converted as fat. So لازم نعرف إنه if I have an excess in calories, the glucose pyruvate to acetyl-CoA, acetyl-CoA بدل ما يروح Krebs cycle. So we should know that. لكن نحنا شو قلنا؟ قلنا glucose will give me pyruvate. Pyruvate will give me acetyl-CoA. Acetyl-CoA will undergo Krebs cycle. هون عم قول sometimes if I don't need much energy, acetyl-CoA instead of starting the Krebs cycle will decide to be converted into fat. So the carbs can give me a deviation to be converted into fat. But I cannot go the opposite pathway. ما فيي من الفات أعطي carbs. Why? Because the passage from pyruvate to acetyl-CoA is irreversible. حعيد. نحن قلنا glucose, one glucose will give me two pyruvate. Two pyruvate will give me two acetyl-CoA. Had two acetyl-CoA. Either they go Krebs cycle or إذا عندي excess of energy, excess of ATP, so automatically the two acetyl-CoA can be converted into fat. So this is how I can convert carbohydrates into fat. بس going back from fat to carb is impossible. Why? لأنه إذا بدي أرجع يعني عم برجع fat acetyl-CoA عم برجع acetyl-CoA to pyruvate. ما في أرجع acetyl-CoA to pyruvate لأنه this the enzyme is irreversible. So I cannot synthesize carbohydrates from fat, but the opposite is possible. Do you have any question? Do you have any question? Omar is typing. Do you have any question, Omar? Hope it is clear. So again, the Krebs cycle part is very important. So I will summarize again. Please, guys, listen to me. بلشنا نحن من الglycolysis, okay? إلنا نحن one glucose will give me two pyruvate through the glycolysis. بس شفنا أنه through the glycolysis, we have a net ATP, two ATP, because we are releasing four, we are consuming two, we have a net of two. And we release two NADH. هل NADH اللي هني released through the glycolysis يلي هني released through the passage from pyruvate to acetyl-CoA واللي هني released through the Krebs cycle كلهم بجمعوا بعض بالآخر بيعملوا شيء اسمه electron phosphorylation to be converted into ATP. Okay, من نترك براسنا أنه 1NADH is converted into 2.5 ATP, 1FADH2 is converted into 1.5 ATP. So again, one glucose gave me two pyruvate. Pyruvate, ما في فوت Krebs cycle لحاله. Pyruvate should be converted into acetyl-CoA. So بصير عندنا passage, two pyruvate will give me two acetyl-CoA. And then the two acetyl-CoA will undergo the Krebs cycle. Wait, they will release. كل 1 acetyl-CoA will release 2 CO2. يعني 2 acetyl-CoA will release 4 CO2. They will release as well NADH. They will release FADH2 and ATP. Okay? هلا ال NADH وال FADH2 مع ال NADH البقوي بيروحوا بيعملوا electron phosphorylation. Not كله of ATP هو 30 to 32 ATP. So hope أنه يكون clear. If you have any question, please feel free to ask.
You are currently the only person in this conference.